it's impossible to take my shirt off when I'm pumped.
Good job. Good job.
Friendship. Welcome back. We are hitting a little push day today. Got the jersey on, so you know it's gonna be a good one. A lot of incline work, incline flies, incline presses, prime machine press, and then some kind of accessory work. So we're gonna fail a lot today because it's a higher carb day. So should be spicy. That was heavy. Maybe 13, I think 13, but we'll just keep there, see if we can match, maybe get 12, maybe 11, and then hit a higher rep set, but chest is feeling good. Maybe 11, so we'll drop the weight a little bit and go try and hit a set of 12 to 15. Chest is pumping. Okay, pump it out. I hate that I make that sound after every fucking set. But moving on to flat. press this now. I don't know. I mean, I feel like Luka's just putting on for Slovenians everywhere, though. You can't just expect every Slovenian to be Doncic. A little faster tempo, but we got 12 reps with the full stack, so just trying to control the weight rather than really getting super fixated on time under tension. A lot of ways to wave intensity. Pump it. Pump it. As a subscriber or as a poster? You don't just post it and be like, okay, my dick's viral. Come and get it. That's what she was telling me. She's like, you have no idea. Like, the shit that I have to post, like, on Reddit, on all these other, like, on Craigslist. I'm like, damn, Craigslist? I honestly think you just have to not care. Because it's going to get out there anyways. Like, the moment you put yourself out there like that, eventually, it's going to circulate to enough people that someone's going to know you, and they're going to tell everyone else that they know that knows you, and it's just going to blow up. It's just like, you can't ever expect to do porn or OnlyFans or anything and be like, and have everyone in the world know about you except for the people you know. You know? Unless you're going to be like fully anonymous or like never show your face, never show all your tattoos, like.
Especially the big adapter, but like the adapter.
No, it must be some other bearded white dude with an adapt tattoo.
I don't think I would have been okay with her family knowing that, but I mean, and I don't think they would have been okay.
I don't know, I mean, because to me, like everything, like fitness, like running a business, like anything, the first part of it is exciting, but it's fucking like so hard that people can't stick with it. Right? So like you starting an OnlyFans is no different. Like unless you already have a huge platform, you're not gonna be successful for a very long time, and you're gonna be degrading yourself for a very long time. Yeah, I had what I call preventative punishment, which was basically like my older brother fucked up, he got in trouble, and so then they would be more restrictive of me because they didn't want me to do what he did. It's like, oh, you think I'm being this bad person, and I'm not, and I'm being punished for being a good person, so why don't I go be this person that you think I am anyways? Because at least I'm going to go have fun while I'm going to later be punished for it anyways. Yeah, it's easy to kind of get lost in the sauce. But the thing is like, when you look at the way generational trauma is kind of like passed down, is it's always like this Newton's cradle pendulum of like, my parents were super strict, so I'm gonna be really relaxed. But then my kids are probably gonna be a little bit more strict than I was, and then they're gonna be a little bit more relaxed, and just gonna swing from generation to generation. Because you're always just trying to find this perfect balance in the middle, which is unobtainable. My parents were super relaxed, but their being so relaxed made it seem like they didn't care. So I see like my siblings being a little bit more attentive, where it's like eventually they're gonna think like maybe their kids are gonna be like, this is too much. Let me back off when I have kids. And it's just like, you're never gonna get it right. Like nobody is a perfect parent. Nobody's a perfect anything. We just wanna be jacked. That's all that matters. My kids just wanna be jacked too. Ohio in March? It's a little frigid. The only way I'm gonna do that is if I'm on stage showing the world my shrinkage.
Look how shriveled up it is. Come on.
Y'all still looking for a couples therapist or for you? I like the girl I use. I can send you her info.
Okay.
Her name's, she does in person now too. I don't feel like, most of the time I feel like if I do therapy too often, it's just me talking a lot.
Yeah, you're talking a lot.
It was Abraham Lincoln's wife, I think, originally said something along these lines, but I heard someone else say it recently, is it's hard to hate up close, right? It's like the idea that, like, if you know everything that someone else has gone through in their life, it's much easier to understand why they are the way that they are, the way they do things that they do. Right, because you can justify, it's like, realistically, we're probably, like, they're doing what they think they have to do at that time. Híjole. I said híjole, not frijole.
Oh, thanks. Your arms are big.
I honestly don't think that I will ever be like, yeah, my arms are big enough. Like, because I just feel like they're growing, but I think everything else is growing proportionally. So I'm like, man, my biceps, like, they're getting bigger, I feel like. They're more vascular. But, like, my shoulders still look so much bigger.
See, my shoulders, I know they're getting stronger. I don't know if they're getting much bigger. They can, like, maintain. I can maintain at 230 for at least another 2 months. I'll probably believe you said that one, but I'll probably cut it.
What are you doing for shoulders right now? Like, what's your typical shoulder workout?
Arsenal press. Then I go cable front delt raises.
Uh-huh.
And then either I'll do the lateral raises or I'll just do the tables.
Yeah. You're probably not doing enough rear delt work. All your pressing work is going to work a lot of front delt.
Yeah.
So that's why, like, the only, like, isolated shoulder work I do is, like, laterals.
Yeah.
On both my push days. And then I have pulls, like face pulls on all my pull days and on my push day too. There's 3 days a week that I'm doing face pulls. And it's not like just part of the warm-up, it's like it's working weight, trying to grow my rear delts a lot. And then honestly, yeah, a lot of like really like just trying to get real heavy on this machine for laterals. Higher reps when I do dumbbells and cables. And then shoulder pressing, of course, but like most of my shoulder volume comes from laterals because my front delts are already getting so like developed with all the incline work that I do, all the pressing work that I do. I'd say if you just shift towards a lot more like incline pressing and a lot of like lateral raises and face pulls, so you work more medial and rear delt and let all the pressing stuff take care of your front delts. Like front raises, if they feel good, maybe as like a finisher,
they don't
feel good.
Bottom.
We're gonna get one more set of triceps here and then a little pump check before lunchtime. That is a wrap for today. Push day here at Adapt, Dallas, Texas. Rocking the Adapt Fitness jersey, me and Jeremy both. So we are both looking jacked per usual, but a little extra just because that's the way it goes. And now we're gonna eat. Get over here. Come rep yo city. I just put it back on. It's impossible to take my shirt off when I'm pumped. Friendship. We show it, and then we swap.
Player, there you go.
And we shake hands, take a picture, and then you. And then we hit the flex.
And then one more tackle. All right, bro. All right, bro. I need that shirt.
Yeah, we can't wear each other. That's how you get staff.